theories. Jean Forte responded by saying, well, he marked September 11th in view. I could have spent the time writing bizarre so-called letters. A Hellgate High School senior and his friends are hosting a river cleanup this weekend. He formed a river restoration group called Montana Clean Streams due to the Park Fork Coalition not being able to do their annual cleanup. And his appreciation for Missoula, he got the idea to do one himself. And those who show up will be separated into groups to work on different parts of the river.
Despite all the cleanup efforts that have been made in Missoula, there's still trash along the riverbanks and definitely still trash in the river.
The river cleanup, those wanting to participate will meet at Karras Park on Sunday, and the event will go from noon to 4 p.m. Garbage bags will be provided. Missoula had a close call for families working here about how frantic attempt to rescue family members from a fast approaching fire. And what happened next?
We're tracking a ridge of high pressure, which means a lot of sun across western Montana, but a shift in wind is likely going to bring some wildfire smoke into the region this weekend. I'll break down what you can expect as far as wildfire smoke, danger, and those warming temperatures in my full forecast.
Yeah, but you left out the part where you killed the guy, but there was no weapons of mass destruction. When you think about it, that makes killing him what now?
Murder.
They wanted to cut our health care, but we refused to roll over. We're making them millions of dollars a year profit. Let me lock it up. So we all just got sorted out a plan, and we're out of the job.
You may not see
that French multinational anyway locked them out. We reached out to the governor's office. He responded right
I don't think it's murder if you're doing what your country tells you to, but I think it was wrong.
I'm Steve Bullock, the designer of this message.
This week, come follow each evening. Jay Lethal takes on Jordan Jess and Jonathan Gresham Vice Peter Hewlett. And the first round of ROH, your general election on ROH TV.
The Labor Day sale of Frontage Row has been extended, so the more you buy, the more you save. Save $100 on every thousand you spend. Plus 5 years no interest and free shipping. But don't wait. The extended Labor Day sale at Frontage Row ends soon.
3, 2, 1, get ready. It's our 3-day breakfast and cereal sale at Rosar's. Honey Nut Cheerios, Fruit Loops, Trix.
That's already happened.
Many more, all on sale for
$1.79. Oh, yeah, I think it started yesterday and goes till tomorrow.
Varieties only $1.79 each. Dole bananas only 39 cents per pound. And much, much more at our 3-day breakfast and cereal sale this Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. Only at Rosar's.
New video tonight shows firefighters surrounded by flames as they drive through the Holiday Farm fire in Central Oregon. And now we're hearing incredible stories of survival from families who escaped the flames east of Eugene. Tammy Matasa reports from Springfield, Oregon.
Betty the Subaru. That's what we've called her for years. She's a mom's car.
Oh my goodness. Oh goodness.
Has become the reminder of what she and her family.
It's all melted.
Yeah, I try not to think about that one. It's really bums my positivity out.
Tiffany's home in Blue River has been reduced to ashes. Monday night, she headed home to work only to find out the raging Holiday Farm fire was knocking on her front door. Her six-year-old daughter, niece, and sister were still inside the house.
She says, Tiffany, there's no way for us to get out. And I told her, you have to get the girls, wet their blankets.
Tiffany turned around, rushing to get them, but she wrecked her car that she was in at the time. She begged the sheriff deputy to give her a ride home, but they couldn't get there with the flames. Luckily, firefighters rescued her sister and the little girls.
My kids alive, that's all I care about. I can't say anything else. Like, my kid is alive, and it was very close.
A close call many who escaped are still trying to process while feeling thankful.
Never in my life did I imagine anything like this happening.
And we're not alone. It wasn't a freak accident. It's the entire town of Blue River. I am in this with every single person in this parking lot.
In Springfield, Oregon, Tammy Watasa, Como News.
Oh, I'm glad they're okay.
Well, right now, a live look over Bozeman from our BC Montana weather camera. Really looking beautiful out there, but it's also warm and very dry. Not good for fire danger. We're up close after Brady Brewster. She's tracking that and a lot more. We go to her live. Brady.
Yeah, so it looks nice and clear down in Bozeman. Haven't quite seen that wildfire smoke move in there yet, but this is a live look over Kalispell. You can see in the distance, we do have some hazy skies here.
Seeing all those big fires on the west coast were burning before that one started, and they're burning after it was out. Usually it's Missoula that has that shit and not Bozeman, but I'm glad they got it for a change.
If you have any photos or videos, we'd love to see them. Share them at nbcmontana.com/shineIn. So this is a look at the smoke that we're seeing so far. Of course, it is coming from those fires burning Washington, California. And we're seeing medium to heavy smoke, or really medium to light right now, I would say. But as we head into the weekend, if you look at this right here, I'm thinking we're probably going to go more towards the heavy side in some parts of western Montana. So that's what we're expecting for our weekend. But first, let's talk about a little bit of football this evening. By 7 p.m., up and around the Flathead, we've got a couple of games at Whitefish and at Glacier. 77 degrees at 7. We'll be sitting at 65 by 9 p.m. and by 10 p.m., 61 degrees up and around the Flathead. Overnight tonight, 45 Kalispell, Whitefish, 50 in Lakeside, as well as over in Big Fork. We'll see 46 in Missoula, 43 in Phillipsburg, 47 in Hamilton, 40 in Butte, 39 degrees overnight tonight in Bozeman. So here's a look at our smoke tracker. Over the next few days, and especially even tonight into tomorrow, we'll see more of that smoke move in. So Bozeman, you guys could start to see just a little bit more of that overnight tonight and into tomorrow. The worst of it, I do think, is mostly going to stay around west central and northwest Montana. So areas of smoke into the weekend around Bozeman, the heaviest of that will be in the Bitterroot Valley, in the Kalispell, those areas. So we're going to continue to monitor that. That's